artificial intelligence, misunderstood men. According to McKinsey & Company, artificial intelligence is the ability for technology and to perform cognitive functions we usually associate with human minds. This includes learning and creative aspects. Some examples of these abilities are ChatGPT, which uses natural language processing to create human-like conversation dialogue, social media algorithms, which gather user data and make personalized feeds and advertising, and deepfakes, which use a form of AI known as deep learning to make digitally altered video and photo media. These examples are only a few of the already existing AI platforms that are used every day. But why would we want to implement AI further? The reason that AI is continuing to be implemented into both everyday life and professional life is that it has invaluable and unique benefits for both of these areas. For example, artificial intelligence is known to be a positive influence when it comes to enhancing workers' productivity, and it has shown that as much as 81% of office workers say that it does so. Enhanced worker productivity can contribute to an increase in the quality of life from AI. Another aspect of AI that can help with increased quality of life is social media mental health algorithms. This is shown to be 70% effective in detecting mental health issues, and this is shown by Priscilla Rooster, a medical doctor based out of Louisville, Kentucky, who is conducting a study on the efficacy of AI models for this aspect. Although there are many benefits to implementing AI in both personal and professional life, there are also many issues that need to be addressed. A large part of the concerns related to the use of AI are ethical and mistrust issues. One concern is that artificial intelligence is using personal information, such as financial information and addresses, to train data, to use as training data. Such data leaks can be devastating. This is shown by the Wells Fargo Bank data leak, which left 3.5 million accounts open to third-party access. Another concern that has been shown to be a problem in recent years is the misuse of deepfake technology. This technology can manipulate photos and videos and make it seem like someone has said or done something that they have not done. This can have drastic negative consequences for both their personal life and professional lives if something negative were to come out showing them. With all of the opportunity for the misuse of AI, it's natural that there's been widespread mistrust among the public. Up to 80% of Americans are worried about their data being used to train AI models, according to a study done by CoStar. All of these issues lead to a rising sense of mistrust that must be addressed so we can use AI to our advantage.
As a group, we extrapolated three main overarching problems from these public concerns. The first problem we came up with is a general lack of knowledge surrounding AI. TheConversation.com reports that advanced AI is currently unexplainable to people not within the field. NIST.gov, an organization a part of the U.S. Department of Commerce, echoes this and calls it the unexplainability problem. Furthermore, a Pew Research Center survey found that 1 in 3 Americans are not able to recognize all 6 of the most prevalent use cases of AI. This further showcases the ignorance that surrounds AI as of now. The second problem we came up with is a theme of mistrust surrounding AI. This theme of mistrust is already echoed by the public, but is validated by the Wells Fargo's bank leak and the fact that 80% of Americans are worried about their personal information being used to train AI. Finally, the third problem we came up with is people using AI for nefarious purposes. This can be shown by deepfakes. Overall, there is a consistent lack of knowledge and theme of mistrust surrounding AI that makes it impossible for people to take advantage of its great amenities. After considering these overarching problems, we came up with 2 solutions. The first solution we came up with is implementation and education. And then the second solution we came up with is legislation. Both of these solutions may seem unorthodox at first, however, both address our overarching problems.
In order to implement AI into education, we must incorporate AI in every class. For this to happen, both teachers and students need to have knowledge regarding AI and how to use it. For starters, teachers need to go to workshops and learn about AI from professionals. Then they can relay the information to the students that they have learned about AI. Now we are ready to completely implement AI into education. Now, there is an issue of using AI for irresponsibly. Dr. Lori Burney, the Institute of Management Accountants professor, proposes that teachers need to inform their students the importance of using AI appropriately. way to enforce this is by using a possible code of conduct. Teachers need to explain the limitations of AI and address the fact that students cannot use AI to complete their assignments for them.
The
implementation of education in AI
will
increase the familiarity and the use of AI, which will increase the understanding of AI in the general public.
Legislature regarding AI would have to acknowledge and make laws for our three overarching problems. The first law that would have to be made is to mandate sufficient documentation of AI. And the second law that would have to be made would add consequences for nefarious uses of AI, like deepfakes.
Both of our proposed solutions, implementation of AI in education and new legislature, come with various benefits but also limitations. For the benefits of implementation in education, there will be an end in mistrust that previously resulted from ignorance. According to Nancy Nasser, a researcher in Next Generation Science Standards, mistrust can start to end in the classroom. Under our solution, students will obtain a fundamental understanding of AI through experience and lectures on how AI can be used ethically. Besides the aforementioned benefits of AI, the implementation of it creates an additional benefit that is an important life skill, deeming information trustworthy. Bernie asserts that when students use AI in the classroom, they should be required to judge whether or not the outputted information is valid or reliable. The benefits of the new legislature include a prevention of the misuse of AI as it makes these various misuses crimes. The one stipulation to this is that for these laws to be effective, there must be a significant amount of enforcement. The Minnesota House of Representatives found that most laws were effective when the chance of being caught was greatest. So properly enforcing these laws is a necessity. These new laws can also alleviate some of the mistrust surrounding AI, as many of the public's concerns are now being dealt with by the government. Moving to the limitations of implementation in education, we understand that the solution will be costly. Institutions will have to pay for both faculty, learning, and technology, which will ultimately cost taxpayers. Additionally, although implementation creates an understanding of AI, it will not directly address all the ethical concerns the public has. For the limitations of the new legislature, similarly to implementations in education, there are cost issues. Not only will there be costs with making the laws and passing them, but also, and even more so, upholding those laws. In addition, despite the legislature ridding the AI landscape of the misuse of it, it does not address the widespread ignorance surrounding AI. Instead of teaching the general public about AI and letting them experience its benefits, the solution simply restricts how AI can be used.
Now, the best solution we found for this problem is the implementation of AI into education. The implementation addresses all three of our problems. Implementation allows for the public to have a lifelong education of AI, while legislation doesn't really give you education at all. Both implementation and legislature address the mistrust in AI, but implementation addresses it more heavily. Implementation allows for the public to personally use and understand AI, while legislature just tells you where the knowledge comes from. Now, previously mentioned, the two limitations to this cost and ethical concerns can also have some possible solutions to them. For cost, institutions need to encourage students to bring their own devices and for educators to explore AI on their own. This way, the institutions pay less and the educators see themselves the benefits of implementing AI into the classroom. The ethical concerns can be addressed by the fact that a better understanding of AI can inspire the work of the public to eliminate the possible unethical use of AI. In conclusion, the implementation of education in
Grayson's findings dealt with the ethical concerns of AI. This, at first, I didn't totally understand it. I didn't dive a whole lot into the concerns, but he mentioned how deepfakes, and for example, how deepfakes and other related issues are really impactful to society. So, that really helped shape our overall presentation, how we would state our solutions and how we would overcome limitations and the various pros and cons of each, because we would have to address them with respect to the various ethical concerns that we brought up.
Tony, describe how the content of the team presentation was changed as a result of group discussion.
So our group discussion mainly focused on the differences between legislature and education. So what we wanted to come up with is we discussed the pros and cons of each, and by doing so, we realized that our path led to education being the most successful implementation of AI, being able to be spread through the public knowledge, so people would have less of a fear of it, and the mistrust would go down, therefore, because of that.
Okay, Grayson, what is an example of a compelling argument from one of your peers' individual reports that you decided to exclude from your team presentation and why?
So, Luke had a lot of stuff on how personal learning can negatively affect someone, and that's why we didn't explicitly include personal learning, but we didn't mention it as a negative because it was a bit too specific and we didn't have the time budget for it.
And Brady, how did the group decide to include Tony's perspective, lens, and conclusion into the overall presentation?
Well, so Tony's paper had a whole lot of benefits of AI, like benefits of AI, which we decided as a group would be good background or context to our problem. So we went through and picked out multiple benefits that we explained and then were able to show the problems, but then show like why the benefits outweigh the problems and the benefits going into the implementing into our solution.